Hello, welcome to my tutorial, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can use image sequence properly. And this is the example here. So what I did is I applied the image sequence as a texture and just slowed it down a little bit and looped it. So I'm going to show you the process. So I'm going to assign a new material first, and I'm going to use the emission color for the texture. So I'm going to connect the file node, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up a very first file, the very first image of the entire sequence. So let's open this up and make sure you check on this use image sequence. So it will run through, but it will only run through once, and the reason for that is basically it's setting the image number as the current frame of your scene. And apparently I have more than 3 frames in the scene, so it will go over 3, which is more than the total number of the frames my sequence. So I'm gonna divide it by 3 and get the remainder value of that. So if we divide it by 3, the remainder value can't be over 3, so that's the perfect solution for us. So in order to get the remainder value, you can just put a percent mark and put whatever number you want to divide this number. So put it, hit edit, it will repeat. So now it's looping, so the next part is slowing this down. To slow this down, I'm gonna add a condition for this expression to be run. So what I would do is put in if statement, and the condition would be frame, the remainder value of frame divided by whatever rate you want. For example, if I want to run it every 8 frames, you can just put in 8 and equals 1. That's the condition here. So if you do it, it will slow it down. But the problem is the order of the sequence is kind of twisted, because this should be increasing by 1 every time, but it's increasing by 8 since we run it every 8 frames. So what we should do is divided by 8, or whatever number you put here. So basically what I did is, this is the total number of the frame in your sequence, and this number here is the refresh rate. So quite straightforward. So let's run it again. Perfect. I used this technique for the traffic light for my timeless animation, and you can apply it for something like this. So thank you for watching, and please subscribe. Thank you.